tarnished ideals is giving way to a responsibility era, and it won't be long now. We will reduce tax rates for everyone in every bracket. On principle, those in the greatest need should receive the greatest help. When America uses force in the world, the cause must be just, the goal must be clear, and the victory must be overwhelming. And to lead this nation to a responsibility era, a president himself must be responsible.
Simply stated, there is no doubt that Saddam Hussein now has weapons of mass destruction.
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 We agree that the Iraqi dictator must not be permitted to threaten America and the world with horrible poisons and diseases and gases and atomic weapons.
What you get with Bush again and again is this sort of bait and switch. And you know what I think the biggest one of all that he pulled off was substituting Saddam Hussein for Osama bin Laden.
Evidence from intelligence sources, secret communications, and statements by people now in custody reveal that Saddam Hussein aids and protects terrorists, including members of Al-Qaeda.
I want to put into the record, Mr. Chairman, a page from this document put out by the Bush administration, the network of terrorism. It was put out a month after 9/11, a page that says countries where Al-Qaeda or affiliated groups have operated. Iraq is not listed.
I believe we need to encourage personal responsibility so people are accountable for their actions. And I believe in government that is responsible to the people.
In this probe, the president himself says those responsible would be held accountable.
If there's a leak out of my administration, I want to know who it is. If the person has violated law, the person will be taken care of.
Yeah, exactly, Roberts.
Given recent developments in the CIA leak case, particularly Vice President Cheney's discussions with investigators, do you still stand by what you said several months ago, suggesting it might be difficult to identify anybody who leaked the agent's name? And do you stand by your pledge to fire anyone found to have done so?
Yes. And finally, that's up to the U.S. Attorney to find the facts.
Mr. President, you said you don't want to talk about an ongoing investigation, so I'd like to ask you, regardless of whether a crime was committed, do you still intend to fire anyone found to be involved in the CIA leak case? And are you displeased that Karl Rove told a reporter that Ambassador Joe Wilson's wife worked for the agency on WMD issues?
We have a serious ongoing investigation here. I would like this to end as quickly as possible so we know the facts. And if someone committed a crime, they will no longer work in my administration. This was a lengthy trial and a serious matter, and a jury of his peers convicted him, and we've got to respect that conviction. I had to make a very difficult decision. I weighed this decision carefully. I thought that the jury verdict should stand. I felt the punishment was severe. So I made a decision that would commute his sentence.
Mr. President, federal sentencing guidelines call for jail time in these kinds of cases of perjury and obstruction of justice. Why do you feel otherwise? And are you worried that this decision sends a signal that you won't go to jail if you lie to the FBI?
I took this decision very seriously on Mr. Libby.
I considered his background, his service to the country, as well as the jury verdict. I felt like the jury verdict ought to stand. And I felt like some of the punishments that the judge determined were adequate, should stand. But I felt like the 30-month sentencing was severe. I made a judgment, a considered judgment. So I made a decision that would commute his sentence.
And I believe in government that is responsible to the people.
In that official White House email right here at the White House, they have gone missing.
There were, between March of 2003 and October of 2005, apparently over 5 million email that were not preserved.
Before the Senate Judiciary Committee today, Karl Rove's former deputy, Sarah Taylor, refused to answer many of the questions asked of her about the firings of those 9 federal prosecutors. Former White House counsel Harriet Myers won't even be showing up to a similar hearing tomorrow in the House.
Well, I respectfully declined to answer the question.
I don't recall being a Senator, I don't recall specifically I don't have any recollection about mechanics that I don't recall making any. I don't recall ever saying, I don't recall ever doing that. Senator, I don't recall that I made any decisions of that day. I don't recall.
Mr. Karl Rove, the President of the United States has just decided he's going to exert executive privilege and not allow his top political advisor to testify before Congress.
I trust you. I trust local people to run their own schools. I trust you.
We're in some serious trouble here, boys and girls. Here's the question. Does it concern you that your phone company may be voluntarily providing your phone records to the government without your knowledge or your permission? If it doesn't, it sure as hell ought to.
A secret Pentagon database with details about anti-war protests and activists.
Pentagon documents obtained by the ACLU provide new details on how even Quakers and churches came to be labeled threats worthy of the attention of the military. The documents also suggest for the first time that agents of the Department of Homeland Security played a role
in... We should help people live their lives, but not run them. I'm asking for your vote.
I'll get on the roof. Shot, make sure I'm happy.
Yeah.